Good morning, everyone. Hope you're having a terrific Tuesday. We've got all kinds of fun things happening here. Malou is with the lead singer for Matchbox 20, Rob Thomas. Just as excited.
I'm so excited.
And we're going to introduce you to an inspiring teenager who has cashed in big time on the candy business.
I know, that's so crazy. And with Mother's Day coming up this Sunday, Dr. Tess is here with a mommy makeover. But we are starting this morning with a guy who can give your home a facelift in a hurry.
We have another room that's almost identical in size.
So this was your formal dining room, right?
Yes.
Do you guys use it?
We do sometimes.
It's a great space. I don't love the wall covering. The sconces are kind of great.
This is a great size room. You could probably get rid of your clothing rack.
All right, well, we first fell in love with Thom Filicia on Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, and he is now the star of Get a Room, Thom. It is so great to see you, and the spotlight seems to just keep following you wherever you go. I can't believe that you are celebrating 20 years
as
a designer.
I know.
You must have started when you were like five.
Well, it's actually 20. That's 20 years in my company. So,
okay.
So I was actually working for like in the business probably 6 or 7 or 8 years before that, before I opened my own company. Yeah, and then we're also celebrating, this fall we'll be celebrating 10 years in the product division.
So great.
Yeah, for our home collection.
And I imagine it's just evolved and changed so much, and you've just seen so much.
Well, I would say it's evolved. I don't know if it's changed. It's definitely evolved.
And,
you know, things sort of happen slowly in the design world.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like fashion, but it's still fun.
So what do you do? Like that clip, what do you do when you walk into a dining room and someone has a clothing rack in there? Like, what do you say?
You know, the most interesting thing about that is that she is a very stylish woman. You know, she's dressed perfectly and very elegantly. And she works in sort of, you know, she's a editor of a very sort of well-known magazine. So you're shocked that that's the way she's living.
Yeah.
And the house is really beautiful. She lives in this really gorgeous house. So it's a little alarming.
you're like, what happened to this room?
It's not what Carson and I thought we were going to walk into.
Right.
So we were a little taken aback, but it was fun. And actually that transformation was really amazing.
And you're really good friends with Carson. So this must have just been so much fun to do.
Oh yeah. We've had so much. It's really been a lot of fun for us to work together on Get a Room, sort of brought us back together. And we're friends, so we see. I was just with him in Palm Springs. We both emceed an event, and we had a ton of fun, and it was really hilarious. And we never follow our scripts.
Aww.
And we always kind of like do everything sort of on the fly, and it makes it a lot more fun. And
but the spontaneity.
The OGs. I mean, you guys are the original Queer Eye for the Straight Guy.
I know. It's kind of crazy. I mean, I'm actually, it's interesting. I'm happy that that's even a thing, that there's an OG. Because it's great that the brand is still moving forward and continuing. And we really like the guys, and they're awesome, and love what they're doing. And the fact that that brand is still relevant, it's really wonderful. So that's a cool thing.
And then you also have the Traditional Home. You're on the cover.
Yes.
2019. I mean, that's huge.
Yeah, we're on the cover of Traditional Home this month for a house that I did in the Hamptons. That's actually the pool house that you're seeing right
Gorgeous.
Now. That's me in the pool house. It looks like it's my pool house.
Do you ever feel like you just don't want to leave? You're like, I designed this. I'm staying. Yeah. I'm moving in.
Yeah. It's a really fabulous house. And interestingly, I grew up with both of the owners. It's interesting. The wife grew up on my street and in my neighborhood. And so the husband used to play tennis against one of my best friends all the time.
Man.
And he used to beat him every single time. So it's kind of hilarious.
All right.
We need some tips for affordable, how to spruce up your home for the summer.
Okay. Well, I mean, I think how to spruce up your home affordably for the summer. I mean, easy tips are certainly for the summer. It's all about editing.
Okay.
You know, I mean, I think, you know, here we are at spring, you know, sort of spring cleaning, but you know, even beyond just cleaning and sort of getting things freshened up, it's really about editing and sort of what you put in is very important, but also sort of what you remove and take out is really great. Also just like refresh, maybe like simple things like pillows and throws, bring in greenery, roll up a rug, you know, expose the floor, just make it feel fresh and light. I also think that, you know, I love some rooms, you know, we'll do things like, you know, take the window treatments down and just do simple bamboo matchstick blinds from like one of the sort of big box stores that are like $12 each.
Yeah.
Simple things like that just make it feel sort of fresh, a little bit different. Of course, a coat of paint. can go a long way.
Paint's like, no paint.
And we always do this thing, Carson and I always make these jokes, we call it paint on architecture, but where you do fun things where you just take two colors of paint and you do sort of stripes on the wall, make it feel a little bit beachy, a little bit more relaxed. Have fun, you know, we all call it like paint parties where all you need is a six pack, a good friend, and a couple can of paint.
All right, you're going to have to come over and help me paint.
Yeah, exactly. Now you're going to be painting your house.
Yeah, I know.
I'll bring the beer, you bring the beer.
Thank you so much, Thom.
Thanks for